Queensland and Western Australia will start rolling back lockdown restrictions from tomorrow, but Victoria is refusing to relax the rules. As Reid Butler tells us, our coronavirus death toll has now climbed to 17.
Catching up with mates in the park and getting out on the water for a barbecue. In other parts of Australia, normality appears to be making a return.
Victoria has done things differently to other jurisdictions.
Big Melbourne retailers and the Queen Victoria Market may have been busy today, but Victoria is still the toughest when it comes to stay-at-home restrictions, as other states start easing up. From tomorrow, Western Australia will allow gatherings of 10 people, and that includes weddings. Queenslanders will, from next Friday, be able to leave their homes for recreational purposes like going for a drive or riding a jet ski or boat. National parks will also be reopened.
Families will be able to have picnics. I think this is a positive move.
Have a picnic in Victoria, though, and you risk a fine of more than $1,600. Police carried out 688 spot checks in the past 24 hours, issuing 87 fines to those breaching restrictions.
We make a judgment about our local circumstances and happy to review it ongoing. I think these are differences across jurisdictions that we should be able to take.
Victoria's death toll is now 17 after a man in his 90s passed away in hospital overnight. In the last 24 hours, there have been 3 new confirmed cases of COVID-19, bringing the state's total to 1,349. One new case is linked to an outbreak at an inpatient psychiatric facility with 16 confirmed infections, part of that cluster. 1,265 people have now recovered, and there are 137 confirmed cases of community transmission. The curve is flattening, but the government is ramping up its medical supply stockpile. 10 million gloves, 5 million isolation gowns, and more than 2 million face shields are due to arrive at this Melbourne warehouse over the next 2 weeks.
It puts in us a very good position to make sure our healthcare workers are protected, that they're not exposed to COVID-19, and that they're able to come back to work the next day.
Alicia, this afternoon we saw a repatriation flight bound for Pakistan leave here from Melbourne Airport, on board around 250 passengers. And now in around 20 minutes from now, we will see a Qantas flight arrive here at the airport from South America. More than 150 Australians and around 20 New Zealanders are on board that flight. Until now, they had been stranded in Argentina. Once they arrive here, they will undergo a medical assessment before being taken to various inner city hotels for mandatory quarantine of 2 weeks. We're told that the Aussies and Kiwis on board commemorated Anzac Day during the long journey, and there were plenty of Anzac Day biscuits to go around. Alicia,
yes.
Very fitting.
No doubt, very relieved. Okay, Reid Butler there, thank you.